And there's a look at the game. Triple H, he's headed to the ring. He has demanded a microphone after what he did last night at Survivor Series. We are back live on Raw, and here comes the game. The Cerebral Assassin, Triple H, who last night defeated Ric Flair in a last man standing matchup at Survivor Series. A matchup that none of us...
Styles, why don't you set up for a second? Triple H did not beat Ric Flair last night at Survivor Series. Triple H destroyed Ric Flair, destroyed the legacy of the Nature Boy. Triple H finally put Ric Flair out of his misery.
Well, you know what? Last night at Survivor Series, I called the game a son of a bitch, and I meant it. He had to use a sledgehammer on one of the greatest names in the history of this business.
All I can say is that right now, you see the flashbulbs popping. You hear the people cheering, because they know that they watched last night one of the very best that has ever been proved why he can do it all in any match necessary. Last night, it just happened to be last man standing, his specialty.
I'll tell you what I will never forget. You guys both know I have an extreme history in sports entertainment. I have never seen anyone use a screwdriver as a weapon.
Right.
That was hard to watch. I will never forget what Triple H did to Ric Flair last night at the Survivor Series.
I said it last night, and I'll say it again tonight. Ric Flair had it coming, and if Ric Flair would have just walked away when he needed to, Triple H would not have had to do what he did.
Explain to me one time, why did Ric Flair have it coming?
By the way, if you want an update on Ric Flair's condition, he's not likely to be coming back.
It's been brought to my attention that some of you think I'm not a compassionate man. But you're wrong. I'm a regular humanitarian. Look at last night, for example. When they took Ric Flair in that ambulance out of Joe Louis Arena last night, I personally made sure that they took Ric to the finest hospital in Detroit. I put him in his own private suite. I made sure he had a nice giant plasma screen TV on that wall, and I made damn sure that they had the USA Network, because I didn't want Ric Flair to miss one single moment of Raw. That's the kind of guy I am. Now, Ric, I know you're sitting in your hospital bed and you're watching me right now, and I just have to say one thing to you, Ric. Stay down. Stay down. I know somewhere in the back of your mind you're thinking, I can come back from this. I can be the Nature Boy once again. But Ric, you can't. Come to terms with the fact that Ric Flair is gone. And Ric, quite honestly, I don't see what you're upset about. I mean, you couldn't have written a better exit from this business if you tried. I mean, look at it like this. You got to go out on top. You got to go out going two back-to-back pay-per-views with the greatest wrestler alive today.
That's what Ric used to say.
And Ric, you know as well as I do, there is no shame in you losing to the best. So Ric, when they let you out of that hospital, go home. Live out what's left of the rest of your life, and don't come back here. Because Ric, you are not wanted anymore. Oh, you have a problem with that. You disagree with what I've done to the Nature Boy? Is that it? The problem is, you know I'm right. You know it's what needed to be done. The reason you're mad is because none of you would have ever had the guts to do anything about it. That's what separates people like me from people like you. You will sit on your ass and talk about it while people like me do something about it. And sure, you can sit out there in that crowd. You can hide behind the anonymity of the mob. And you can run me down. But the fact is, there is not a man alive that will look me in the eye and tell me to my face. So if anybody
Well, here's a man that will look Triple H in the eye, but he's going to have to look down and do it. 7 feet tall, 500 pounds, one half of the World Tag Team Champions. My God, he is huge.
But if I'm not mistaken, Triple H wasn't finished yet.
Well, you may be mistaken. Because Triple H looks finished to me right now.
Yeah, I don't think the Big Show has to say pardon me much in his everyday life.
Well, the Big Show. Why? It's hard to describe.
Yes.
Look at this confrontation.
Look at them eyeing each other down.
The last thing that came out of the mouth of Triple H, there's not a man alive. Well
Big Show looks alive. Yeah,
Big Show looks alive to me.
Triple H is not backing up, though.
He's not a man.
I've known you for a long time. I've let a lot of the things that you've done slide. But after what you did to Ric Flair, I'm here to tell you, to your face, eye to eye, man to man, Hunter, you're a piece of shit.
Oh, God. God. Oh, my God.
You think you're a tough guy. I know you do. See, I don't need a sledgehammer to put someone out of their misery. I can do it with my own bare hands. I told you a few weeks ago that your time was coming. Your time is here now. Question is, do you have the guts to fight me now?
A question posed to the game.
No problem. The problem is Triple H is gutless. He doesn't have a screwdriver in his hand. He doesn't have a sledgehammer in his hand. And he looks gutless to me. He can brag all he wants to about putting Ric Flair out. But what's he doing now? He's backing out.
Driver to sledgehammer would be enough.
The last thing Triple H is gutless. It's the last thing he is.
Wow.